know I'm a few minutes later. If you're watching this video and you don't see the red live, then I'm no longer live. You're watching the replay. So thank you for watching in advance. Welcome, welcome, welcome to our third episode of Saturday Night Chat and Craft. Come on in and say hi. Let me get it on my computer here. Hey, hey, hey. Hi, Angela. Let me pull it up on my computer here. I was running a little behind because I was chatting it up with a sister. Come on in. Make sure you get your tea or your water or your soda. I do not promote alcoholic beverages. Hi, Bookworm. Come on in. I got my tea. Hey, Pam. Let's see. Why is my computer going really slow? I want to be able to catch y'all comments. Hey, Claire Boo. Yes, it's crafty time. You got to get those beanies ready for your show. Come on. There's no excuse right now. This is the time to craft. Hi, Charlene. Why is my computer going so slow? I don't know. Let's try it again. Because I can look at the comments here. Hey, creatively created crochet. Hey, I'm missing people. I don't want to miss anyone, so I'm trying to open it up on my computer. But my computer is having a really hard time right now. I wonder, did my daughter bump the modem? That could be it. Make sure when you come in that you pass by that thumbs up and go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Because this is the day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in it. And we're about to craft. Hi, Donna. We're about to craft and chat it up. So if you guys have any questions for me or anything, go ahead and ask them. I'm trying to pull it up on my computer, but it's not working. Hold on one second, you guys. I want to go see if my daughter maybe bumped the modem or something. Be right back. But in the meantime, in between time, thumb it up and share the video. Okay, so nope, she didn't bump it, so I don't know. My computer is just being retarded right now. Hey, 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 what I missed? Come on in, come on in. So I got my tea here. Ooh, that's a good tea. So what I'm drinking today is the Herbally Teas for Well-Being. This is lemon ginger honey tea infusion. This one's really, really good. I put a little bit of lemon extract in it. Ooh. All right, so what are we going to do today? I want to show you guys from last week. Man, if only my computer would work. Man. Okay. Let's go right here. I'm sorry, y'all. My computer is like, the internet is really slow. That's why I'm glad I'm on my phone internet right now. It's just not wanting to work. Maybe if I restart it. But I don't want to restart it. All right. All right. So, I wanted to show you guys from last week. I did that yarn, that blue yarn that I got from from Tuesday morning. Came out really pretty. It's a really nice snug beanie. So I think this gonna be mine. I have some fur that I'm going to cut and make the fur pom-poms. I bought a bunch of fur from Joann's months ago to where I can make my own furry pom-poms. And so I'm gonna put one of them, like maybe a white furry one, up on here. That's gonna be really cute. Why is my internet? I'm gonna have to restart it. I'm gonna have to restart my computer. Hold on, y'all. Yeah, it came out really nice, right, Clara? And so then I did the other one, that black and white. It made it super thick, so I was like, nah, I can't make a hat that's like really thick. So what I'm thinking about doing is I just did like a tube, and I'm going to connect it. Hi, Lisa. Shalom to you. I had a very, very awesome Sabbath. The fellowship was awesome. It's like our fellowship group is growing. It's cute. Gonna be awesome with her. Yes, it will be. It will be. But here's the other one. So I know what the purple one is gonna look like. That's pretty, y'all, right? And I figure I use it as a cow. I'll use it as a cow. Like, I figure, you know, a cow would be really cute, right? Because a hat would just be way too thick. So I know when I do the purple one that I'll either just make a scarf out of it, or it's my computer, y'all, because it's taking forever just to restart. Hold on. So I thought a cow would be good, or if I do this yarn, I would have to make a cuff with the Addy, so it'd just be one layer instead of folded in half. So I'll have to do a video to show you guys how to do that one. But I thought that one, that was cute. My hair is a mess, y'all. Y'all can't look, y'all can't see that. But that one was cute too. So it's just like one long tube, and I just folded it in half. But look how the colors change. They came out really, really nice. I think, like, if I get the smaller Addy, it is. Hey there, Sister Sharina, my Coty, how you doing? If I get the smaller Addy, or if I try it on Buttercup's little machine, this would be pretty leg warmers. Can you imagine how them leg warmers would turn out? I might have to try it on her thing and see if it'll do, like, really nice leg warmers. Like, because this looked like this could be two leg warmers. So, I could do on the Addy. On the Addy, you can do it in a tube, or you could do it in a panel and go back and forth. So, I've never tried the back and forth before, so I'm thinking I might try that. The back and forth, and just, it'll have a seam. Yes, leg warmers will be really pretty. I might try that. Do it in a panel, and then just sew it together. To where there'll be a slight seam, or maybe get some ribbon and like do the ribbon through where you would put the seam and have it like tie at the top. I just might do that. Y'all, I still got the sniffles. I'm not even fully over it yet. But I wanted to show you guys that. It seems like every time I get on camera. Hey, Marcelle. You working on a, yes, sorry.
I want to show you my baby doll.
You working on a shell beanie? Awesome, huh?
I want to show you my baby doll.
Okay, can you show me later? Huh? Can you show me when I'm done?
Okay.
That's Buttercup, y'all. I don't even know if she can show up in my videos now. These new rules that they got right now that they're about to, that they got for YouTube now is just like, I don't understand them. Hey, Sandrine, I don't understand them. Like, why? Why? I mean, I understand trying to protect the children and all that, but, I did look at my analytics to see, like, well, what is the age group that watch my videos? And from age 13 to 17, for the last 365 days, no one by the age of 13 to 17 watched my videos or my channel. So I guess my channel is not kid friendly, I guess. It's just so confusing. So confusing. Let me see if it's gonna work now. Alrighty, cancel. Let's see if it's gonna work now. Where my admin's at. Hey, Donna. Where my moderator's at. Yes, Creatively Created. It's crazy what they doing now. Okay, it looks like it wants to pop up. It's being really slow, though. But I don't know. So I gotta like really read the fine print. Too many kids who do crafting anymore. Yeah. You said not too many kids. Right. I have to read the fine print and everything to see, because do I gotta go back on all my videos and mark them if they were kid friendly or not? Like, y'all, I have a lot of, yeah, they're not. It's really not, Lisa, it's not. I have a lot of videos. I mean, are they gonna start as of January? I'm not sure. I don't know how that's gonna work out. It is so crazy. Hi, Maya. All right, so what I'm gonna be crafting on today, I gotta figure out which one I wanna do. I wanna do tatting. So I got my tatting needles. And I know, trying to go through my channels on my videos. I'm thinking starting now. So I got my tatting, I got my thread, which one I'm gonna use. Hey sis, thank you. I need a moderator here. I was gonna either tat or I tried the crochet. I show y'all last time this crochet earring? This was my second try, which is a lot better. I'll either try that. I heard the issue. I'm scared with the updates. I know. I heard the issue with the... Oh, yeah. Hi, Rita. And see, a lot of people, you know, like a lot of young people, you know, get YouTube accounts saying that they're 18 or older when they're really not. So really, that what it showed me, my status, could be actually false. It could be a lot of young people watching my videos, but because they didn't tell the truth on their age, it's not really picking that up. Hey, Janet. Hi, Carla. Greetings from Virginia. Hey, don't forget to stop by that thumbs up and thumb it up to let YouTube know that, hey, yep, they could be lying too. Yep. So I don't know what I want to do. I wanted to try. I got these in the mail today. Not today. Yesterday. Let me show y'all. Because I wanted to start doing stitch markers. Especially for y'all who do blankets and stuff. Sneaky kids, I know, right? Man, if only my computer would work. Let me cut it off. Hold on, y'all. You started... Oh, shoot. Sorry about that. Always thumbs up. Thank you, Janet. How are you today? So I got these little bezel pieces. I don't know if y'all can see them. But I was thinking about doing stitch markers, like doing some glitter ones. I got some like micro glitter here. Look at that. And mix it up with just clear resin. Okay. I know who you are, Marwill. You're the one that is awesome. Because you could crochet and you're blind. Like, I just really, like, I was talking to my sisters after the last live. Like, that is amazing. Like, I was just trying. I couldn't do it. A few stitches I got perfect, but then I didn't know what I was doing. Man, if only my computer worked, I can see y'all comments a lot better. Let me sign back on. So what are y'all working on today? What beverage are y'all drinking? I hope it ain't alcoholic, because, you know, that's not good for you. I'm sniffling. Like, I wish I would have blew my nose right before I went live. You thumbs up. Thank you, Maya. I'm doing good, Janet. Thank you. It's the end of the Sabbath, so I'm at the cleanup after this show, this live. Hi, Adele. You Addie and Jessie Boo? Awesome. I should pull the Addie out. I could crochet in my sleep. Girl, you good, then. You good. I could crochet in my sleep, too, like, but not with the actual hook and yarn, like. Thank you for joining in, Adele. Got my gingerbread latte. Ooh, that sounds good. I'm crocheting an off-the-shoulder sweater and sipping lemonade. Love the Addy. Yes, working on crochet sweaters and drinking water. Lemonade, that cool, refreshing drink. So I'm thinking of doing stitch markers, and I haven't used this resin. Yep, that's you. I'm using VoiceOver with my phone, so I'm still new to it. Sorry for the mistakes. No worries. I pretty much can understand what you're saying, so no worries. I was wondering, like, how you typing, girl? That you be typing kind of fast. But no worries. So I have clear resin right here, UV resin. I'm crocheting an ear warmer, and I'm drinking water. Awesome. All right, so maybe my computer is going to work right now. Let's see. Maybe. Crocheting a wood mouse and drinking mucho mango. Working on crochet shawl for gifts. Awesome. Let me see if it's going to pick up now. All right. So I'm going to try a couple of these to see if I can do it. Being mad, being bad, sipping on Sprite and making a brimmed hat. Girl, you need some LaCroix or some bubbly or something. All that sugar and that Sprite. Let me stop. Got my UV light. So I just want to see, because I never use just plain clear resin. And I'm going to add some glitter to it just to see how it'll turn out. And then I'm going to work on a tatting. And I might say the pattern on here. It's a picture I'm going to be looking at, but I'm going to try to figure it out with you guys. I got to pull up that picture too. Okay, YouTube, you want to work now? Okay, let's go. Let me go to my channel. Love glitter. Yes, I do too. Can you see? I love glitter. I love glitter too. I really love glitter. I haven't bought none in a while, which I'm kind of fiending for. Hey, Angie Boo. What are you making tonight? So, I wanted to try this clear UV on these little bezel pieces.
What are you making tonight?
Oh, let me cut that off.
I wanted to try this clear UV.
Hold on. Sorry about that, y'all. Let me cut the... What just happened? Hold on. There we go. I just want to pull y'all chats up on the computer.
Hello from Cranbrook, BC, Canada. I am working on a hairpin lace crochet scarf. I am waiting for my Addy machine to come in the mail. What? Yes. You're so right. I have some sparkling.
Do you need to be drinking that? Yes. Yeah, see, I'm a helper. We are our sister's keeper.
You should have looked at Tana's last box. I'm just ignoring. I'm not looking at it. I'm not giving you the go ahead, Angie. Hi. Be right back, Charlene. Okay. I am from BC, Canada, too. Well, look at there. Lena, Lana. Where can I get tatting needles, please? I know you can get them at... They just flew out, y'all. You didn't buy any? Of course, because you need me to give you the go ahead. So, and I say no. Joann's. Joann's have them. And if you can't find them at Joann's, if you go to hhtatting.com, they have the tatting needles too. If I can get this open. Yep, Joann's. Hi, Jacqueline from North Carolina. Although, if you would have bought some, Angie, I would have been okay with it if you got some for me too. If you share the glitter. So I'm going to try this clear resin. And I'm going to add glitter to it. I got tatting needles at Hobby Lobby. Oh, yeah. Hobby Lobby does carry them too. And one just opened up like an hour away from me. I was thinking about buying some wholesale. That way when people do my tutorials, if they don't have the necessary tools... Thank you, Jessie Boo. If they don't have the necessary tools, they can go straight there, straight to me. Right, share the love. All right, so I'm going to try this litter. I'm going to try this glitter from Mr. Nola's. This is called Vanilla Orchid. We're going to see how it turned out. So I'm just going to add it
I wish I can show y'all down here where I'm doing, but I'm gonna try to bring it up. And I'm gonna just mix it up. Ooh, that pretty. That's so pretty. Look at that. That's pretty. And then I'm gonna drop a little bit in this bezel tool. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button and share. Jessie Boo, can you message Cena? I want her to join in because I just want her to take her mind off things. So have her, tell her to join in. Love the color, right? You see that? Look at that. So pretty. All right, so I'm going to drop a little bit. Actually, what y'all drinking on? What y'all sipping on? I'm going to try this right here. This will be easy. Oh, you did, Jessie Boo. Thank you. I'm making mittens for the first time and drinking Diet Cherry Pepsi. Checking in from Haverhill, Massachusetts. Hi, Betty. Welcome. Hi, DS. I am doing good. How are you this beautiful Saturday night? So I'm just trying to suck it in this little tube so it'll be easier for me to squeeze it in the hole. So I'm going to drop. I wish I could show y'all what I'm actually doing. It's thick. I think I put too much glitter. Peach tea again. Awesome. I am drinking, for those of you who just came in, it's called the Herbery. This is the lemon ginger honey tea, and it's so good. I added a little bit of lemon extract. So good. And I added just a teeny bit of this, what is it, Skinny Girl lemon lavender. So good. Hey, Latanya, welcome. I'm trying to get this out. Okay, there we go. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap. Because then that's something that you guys can actually see me do. This right here, I got to have it flat. Sounds good. I need to find that tea. I got it from Marshall's for only $2.99. If I can get this resin out, y'all. I got it from Marshall's. You probably can find it at TJ Maxx, the sister store, too. They be having a lot of nice teas. People don't be looking, like, in the food section area. They don't be looking in that area. They be having some nice little teas there. I've missed you. I need to show you the what? Music, not tatted earrings. Are you talking about, like, the treble clef? I would tell y'all a little secret. Maybe I could tell y'all a little secret. Yes?
I want to add you something.
Go ahead.
I need to come in to add you.
Okay, go ahead. Just stay right there by the door.
Can I have some... I don't know what to call that.
If you don't know what you call it, how you gonna ask for it? There's no buy drink in there. All right, so I got it in here. So I wish I could show you guys. Let me torch it first. I'm going to tell y'all a little secret. Don't tell nobody, okay? Should I tell y'all? I'm learning violin. I am. You're never too old to learn an instrument. I'm just saying, I'm learning violin and piano at the same time. So watch, y'all go. Y'all gonna hear me coming on with violin. Y'all gonna be like, what is that? And it's gonna be me. I'm just be like, yes, violin. I absolutely love violin. I got one bubble in here and it don't wanna pop. You guys stay tuned for the upcoming video because I got a new intro. You guys, I got a new intro. Dear brother JK did the intro for me and I absolutely love it. I absolutely love it, and I want to get you guys feedback on it. And if you guys do YouTube channels and you want an intro for yourself, then he is the one to go to get it done. He did it super fast. Like, I asked about the intro, and then the next day, like, the next couple of days, he, like, had something already.
And then I kind of asked for a little bit of changes, and he did the changes like that. So it's a little long, but I think what I'm going to do is cut part of it for my outro. So, yeah, so I'm a put up the intro so you guys can give me a your critique and what y'all think of it. Crochet mittens, let's see. Good day from Australia. Hello, is it nighttime right now? Oh, no, morning. Morning for you guys right now. Okay, I'm going to seal this one real quick to see if it works. So I got my UV light. So we're going to check it out. Hey, when you start to crochet again, you play the piano? Buttercup is learning piano too. And so when she was learning piano, I was like, you know what? Why don't I learn? I'm sitting here watching. So she's teaching me too. And so remember those bags that I had to do last week? That was actually my payment for my lessons. So yeah, that paid for my lessons. Hi, Nancy. So yep, I'm learning violin and piano. And it's so much fun. It's a little challenging. You used to play piano too? It's so challenging. I don't know which one I like best, but I know the one I really want to master first is violin, because I think it's so beautiful. So beautiful. I hope I greeted everyone. Donna S., welcome, welcome. I hope I said hi to everybody. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button. We got 34. Let's see if we will beat our record last week, which was, I think, what was it, 42? It's 2 p.m. Sunday. Okay. Yeah, it is 7 p.m. Saturday here in Northern California. Awesome. Well, happy Sunday fun day to you. I don't know how to say your name, but it's a J-Y. Is it Joy? Would that be Joy or Jai? You play both long ago? Awesome. I just really want to learn a string instrument and piano. I just really been into classical music, to be honest, because the music played nowadays. Let's not talk about that. I have a piano and can't play by notes, but show me what to do and I can do it. Oh, nice. That's like my son. He can't read music, but he can play. Like if he hears something, he can then go play what it is. I'm learning music theory, so I'm learning what the notes are, like the music staff, the treble clef, the bass clef. So I'm learning music theory, because if you learn music theory, then it makes it easier for you to play. And if I learn how to read music, then grabbing an instrument and playing something will be a whole lot easier. I always wanted to play a musical instrument. By the way, I'm in Rockland, Illinois. It's very cold here. I bet. Let's see. Is it done? Almost. Sorry, y'all, if I'm sniffling. Angie, are you doing any crafting? Let's see. Jessie Boo is, Jess Handmade Designs is working on her Addy. Somebody about to get they Addy. Y'all, you got to get an Addy. When I did my recital, my teacher knew I wasn't reading it, but he said I did good. I do need to learn how to read music. Yeah, it's hard. It's like a whole nother language. Like, the left hand, like right now, I'm learning to play left and right hand at the same time, which is a struggle. And on the piano, on the violin, I know how to play Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. I know how to play Mary Had a Little Lamb. I'm struggling with Jacob's Ladder. I know how to play Farah Jaca. And I know how to play Shortened Bread. Yeah, it ain't the best, but you know what it is when you hear me play. Yeah, so I'm learning. I'm only a month in, about a month and a half in. Can you do over your crescioli? it definitely didn't say what you said, crescioli, but I know what you're saying. Crescioli tutorial, please. I don't think I have a tutorial for the crescioli, but I think I took it down. I took the crescioli pattern for sale down to where I can actually just do the video. Like, I think if I have patterns, I'll just do them. Like, I'm not going to sell the patterns. I'll just share it with you guys. Of course not, Angie. Of course you're not.
What is an Addy? Jeanette said, what is an Addy, y'all? Hold up. Let me see. All right. Look at this. Can y'all see that? Look at that. Isn't that pretty? There's a stitch marker right there. That came out pretty. Oh, yeah. I'm going to play with this a little more. What I like about UV resin is it doesn't harden up unless UV is on it. So I'm going to use this up. I'm going to do a couple more. Next thing you know, y'all, I'm going to have stitch markers for sale. So the Addy, I wanted to go back to that question. The Addy is a looming machine. Let me show you. I got yarn. Oh, look, y'all, I bought some more yarn so I could do some more hats for my husband at the shop. So I got that one. I think these are manly colors, right? And then I got this one here. I think those are manly colors. But this is the Addy. Let me move stuff out the way. This is the Addy machine. It is a looming machine where you could do circular knitting or flat panel knitting. Takes about sometimes less than 30 minutes to do one beanie. Here's one here that I did last week. It's like double knitted basically because you fold it in half. But I did this in like 27 minutes. You got a knitted beanie. That's what an Addy can do. What could you possibly make? Maybe with the knitting stuff that I sent you a while back. I'm just saying. I was just going to say camouflage and you showed it. Yep, I got it. I was about to ask how long it takes to harden. I would say about 5 minutes or less than 5 minutes. That wasn't even 5 minutes. Matter of fact, I'm about to harden another one, so let me just time it. About a minute or two. You thinking about getting some UV resin, Carla? Okay. Yeah, that came out, so if y'all want some stitch markers, y'all know who to come to. Uh-oh, I'm spilling stuff. Hold on. I probably need to do a few of them. How's Buttercup? She doing good. I just told her to stay out of the camera until I figure out like this whole children's COPPA kind of thing. Let me read everything, watch all the videos about it. So I told her to just kind of stay like out of sight. So I haven't had her come in here. Where I live is beautiful. 75. Oh, yeah, that's nice weather. You in Atlanta? Oh, okay. My mom used to live in Atlanta. So what is that? Is that like about 2 minutes and it's just about, oh, it's done. So maybe about a minute and a half to 2 minutes. Here's my second one. And I did not pop the bubbles out this time. There's my second one. So I really used too much resin because now I got to use it up. And then I'm going to pull out the tatting and tat up an earring and see how it turns out. I'm going to try to look at a picture and go by the picture, y'all. So y'all might see me like, it's because I'm trying to figure it out. Do you ever finish the earrings glow in the dark? Nope, I haven't finished them. To be honest, I haven't started them. I'm going to have to email you. But I have a cup order that I need to do. And so I will have resin to work with. Because sometimes I just hate mixing up resin just a little bit. But I have a cup I need to do. So I'll have resin to work with. So I'll definitely be doing the earrings, the glow-in-the-darks for you. I haven't forgot about you, girl. So I'm trying to put a whole... Oh, I just messed that one up. Trying to put a whole bunch of resin in a whole bunch of these. And I just made a mess. You know what cleans up? Wipes. You in Alabama? Yeah, Nancy. I just got to find out what's going on with this whole new guidelines and regulations. I'm not trying to get in no trouble. I'm not trying to get my channel taken away. I feel for those channels that is really not producing much. Like, I do have a second channel. Get out of small mode too. Yeah. Oh yeah. I do feel for those small channels. Like, I do have a second channel. Yes, the Magic Wipes. OVW Real Talk, but I haven't posted on there for years. So that channel probably will get deleted. That's messed up how they if they don't feel like they can make money from you. Like, if you're not bringing in enough money as far as revenues, they could just delete your channel just like that. That's messed up. Okay, don't rush. No worries. Just let me know in an email. I will. But no, I'll probably be working on it tomorrow because I have a cup I need to do. And so I'll be able to finish it up then. I just, like, my resin is, I don't know if y'all probably can't see it, but it's a pump. And so one pump puts out so much resin, it's like I got to do something with it because, you know, once I mix it, it'll harden up. So I'll definitely be working with it. Yes, they can do that, Nancy. They can do that. If they feel like it's all of, they can't make money off of you, then bye-bye. I'm like, woo, I better get on my videos before my channel get deleted. That's why it's really, really good for, like, if the subscribers press that like button, like, yes, right? Hi, Proverbs 31. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Like, if they, you know, press that like button and everything just to show YouTube, like, this channel is worth keeping. Don't delete it. So make sure you press that like button on here. I'm making a mess, y'all. I'm making a mess. What you working on? Proverbs 31. I love that name. Yes, thumbs up, y'all. Thumbs up. Just takes a second. Just take a little second. So look, let me say, can I bring y'all down? So I got them all right here. So I'm going to put the UV light on all of those at the same time. Yes?
I found the lip balm that you were worried about.
Oh, okay. I need some lip balm too. Can you... No, get on the floor. Look, do army crawl. Get on the floor and crawl on in here. Oh, Proverbs 31 yarn. Thank you so much for the super chat. I appreciate that. Come this way. See, you weren't even supposed to show yourself. Get down. They saying hi, Buttercup.
Thank you.
Sorry, y'all. My lips is...
Let me close the door.
No, you don't have to close it. Because I want to hear what you're doing out there. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. For just having a giving heart. I'm making a cow neck warmer. Ooh. That sounds very cozy. Didn't you say, where you located? Because you're in, where you located? I will tell her y'all said hi. When will you crochet again? I saw a wrap scarf sweater I would love to make. You can send the pattern to me if it's a free pattern, but tutorial's coming up soon. I have a crochet tutorial coming up of this earring. I have an ear warmer tutorial, which I kind of switched it. I was going with a more basic stitch, but now I want to do a different stitch, because that way not only will you be learning how to do the ear warmer, but you'll be learning another stitch. So let me see, is this wet? Where's the ones I did already? Okay. I remember when you announced you were expecting. I know, right? She'll be 6 in January, you guys. Knew it wouldn't be long before she needed you. I know. I'm surprised she ain't got to use the bathroom like last time. All right. This UV resin does have an odor to it. Good thing I got the window open. Definitely want to make sure you're in a well-ventilated area when you're using the UV, any type of resin. Thank you,
Mia or Maya? Free pattern on Ravelry, Pam's ombre cowl neck warmer. Oh, okay. Yes, she will be six, going on 13, basically. So I'm just using the UV light to cure it. And I think I am, nope, I got a little bit left. So I'm gonna find, I got a bag of molds. Ooh, how about we make a ring? Yeah, we're gonna make a ring. My UV resin trying to spill. Please keep those in bushfire area here in Australia in your prayers. 500 homes has been lost. Thousands of people have evacuated from their homes. Definitely keep that. Keep the bushfire in Australia. Believe me, I am not new to fires. Like here in California, California is slowly burning up. Yes. Yes, when yes, January 25th, she will be six. Yes, Angie said, absolutely, definitely keep in prayer. It's, man, fires ain't no joke. No joke. I'm just glad the ones that we had here are contained now. Hold on one second, y'all. I'm gonna have to zip the camera up because my nose is running and y'all don't need to see, like, hold on. I'm back. I just think y'all don't need to see all that. Yes, praying for those fires. Like, really, for those of you who say prayer, please say a prayer. That's one thing I'll be like when people be asking for prayer and people be like, yes, I'm gonna pray. Do you really pray? Like, I'll definitely, because I know how it can be to be affected by the fire. I really do. Like, if I had my head covering, I would pray right now, but I don't have my head covered, so... But I will. YouTube notifications are broken. Yes, I believe that because I even noticed some people that I was subscribed to, I had to resubscribe. I pray right away and daily. Thank you, Nancy. If my head was covered, I would definitely pray. You have that on your prayer list in my prayer book. I didn't even know about the fires out there, so this is new to me. I don't watch TV, so I don't know about... Like, usually I'm, like, going on the news on my phone. That's the only way I get the news is on my phone because I have a TV, but I don't have, you know, to where I get regular channels and stuff. I do pray for those in California. So many have been lost there. Yes, like, I don't know how new you are to my channel, but just a year ago, the Paradise Fire, I was affected by that as far as I had to be evacuated for about a week. Someone posted it on my Facebook. Oh, okay. And y'all, I'm slowly drifting away from Facebook, y'all. Like, I don't know. I'm hoping that I'll be able to go to Instagram if I close up my Facebook and come. Oh, shoot. I just touched that. If I close up my Facebook and just go Instagram. Because, see, I can go live there. You don't have TV? Yeah, you shut the cable off. It just ain't nothing good on TV, y'all. We gotta be careful what we watch. Yep, when I did the video being evacuated at the hotel, yep. That was no joke. That's why we're in the process of moving. I just left my site 3 years ago, so I'm just starting to relearn everything. Oh, okay. Nothing good on TV. You are telling the truth. Nothing good. All right. I think those are done. I'm going to just sit that there. I'm going to find. How about we make a ring? I got a ring mold here. I don't know if y'all can see that. So I'm going to try to make a ring. I used to go on Facebook once a day, but now I'm selling. Oh, are you? You need to start a YouTube channel up and be selling it on YouTube. Oh, we got 27 people watching. Oh, make sure you thumb it up. I see 21 people liked it, though. We lost some people, y'all. They probably like, I can't see what she doing. I'm sorry, y'all. Once this is done, I'm done. I'll just go straight to the tatting. Instagram is much better. Yeah, I think because I have an account there, but I haven't been active. It's been like maybe 3 years, 2 or 3 years. So I have an account, but I think what I'm going to do is switch to a business account. That way, like when I do my cups and all of that, I can put them up for sale right away. You don't have Instagram? I will be back. I need to make a phone call. Go ahead, Adele. I'll be here. I need to call my mom, too. She joined us during fellowship, Bible fellowship today. And usually I call her afterwards just to be like, hey, how was that? Did you, you know, get an understanding? And I haven't called her yet, so I need to do that. You only have Facebook. Well, you might have to close out your Facebook and come to Instagram because I'm going to leave Facebook. And that's mostly to witness Jesus. Amen. Are we friends on there? You love Instagram? Yeah, all the social medias, to be honest, is they all kind of crazy, but it's really what you make it to be. Like, my husband didn't want me on Instagram because of the craziness he saw from his customers being on Instagram, and I was just telling him Instagram is what pretty much you make it. If you watching foul, perverted stuff, then that's what your Instagram is pretty much going to show. Me, my Instagram was basically my craft and sharing the word of God. That's it. And that's what it will be, you know, when I start back up. Okay. So I got all of these done. Yep. They are all done. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 stitch markers. And so I think what we're going to do is with this leftover resin, I got a bunch of, let's try a ring. So I'm going to squeeze the leftover resin. It is what you make it. Yes. It is what you make it. As far as a Christian, their main priority should be to share the word of God. You know, if they're not a believer, then pretty much, you know, it can be a whole lot of stuff. But, you know, we got to guard our eye gates, guard our ear gates and everything. So I'm going to put it in this ring. It's all a tool to reach people for Jesus. I've been online naming his name since 1998. Amen. The devil gets into everything, but we have to stand strong together as God's children. That is true. I mean, he invented all this. All right, if I can figure out how you get the resin up in here. Hold up. This thing is tiny. I used to go in chat rooms. Oh, okay. You would go to them like, hey, I'm going to go with a bigger ring thing because it was hard to get it in there. Let's see here. What are you making tonight? Hi, Crafty Fee. Welcome in. I just made some resin, UV resin stitch markers. I'll show them to you in a minute. Right now, I'm just trying to use the leftover that I have and putting it in a ring mold so I can start tatting. I'm going to do some tatting tonight. What are you working on? I got disabled and couldn't go out in person, so God allowed me to go online. Hey, by any means necessary, right? There's a lot of lost people online. Yes. All right, y'all, because I know y'all probably like, I can't even see what she's doing here. I'm trying to squeeze what's left in this tube into this mold. Oh, for some of y'all who just joined, I'll show y'all real quick while I'm trying to wait for this resin to roll. I'm trying to suck it up in this little thing. So, let me set that to the side. For those of you, I tried the blue yarn. It came out really, really nice. And I tried the black
and white yarn that I got from Tuesday Mornings on the Addy. And what I was saying before more people came in is that if I did it in a flat panel, I could probably make this into two leg warmers. It came out. Is Buttercup my only child? No. I have three adult children. Yes, three adult children. I have a 25-year-old, which is Niaja, who used to do Fresh Off the Hook with me. And I have a 24-year-old daughter. And then I have a 22 now. He just made 22 on October 31st. 22-year-old son. Your son, Joseph, loves my videos. Aw. Hi, Joseph. So, yeah, I have three adult children. And then Little Miss Buttercup. I thought I was done, y'all. You can make rings, necklaces, and earrings, too. You're so, girl, make it all. I make it all. Just name something I don't do. No, I'm just playing. I don't do no crochet videos, right? It's been a while. I know. Y'all got to get on me, though. But I know my sister Jess and Angie, Brown Girl Life, and Jess Handmade Designs, they've been getting on me. And now with this new thing with YouTube, I definitely got to get on here and show that I am a viable channel. Like, they need to keep me here. Y'all, I'm still trying to get this. This is going to be a struggle ring. Because it's so thick that it's taking forever to. I've been missing your videos. Thank God I'm on tonight. Thank you, Crafty Fee. I'm glad you're able to make it. You have three grown boys, 28, 23, 21. And then I was blessed with my 11-year-old son, Jeremiah. Yeah. Oh, there's a nice little gap, huh? Yeah. It's a what? I think my son was 17. It's a huge gap. But she is a joy. Your son turned 44 yesterday. Awesome. Belated birthday to him. All right. I'm just going to give up on this because it's taking forever to get out. I'm just have to squeeze it with my hands. Oh, you bought Karen Tea Cakes, $3.99. See? Anytime I can be of help. Anytime. The doctors told me that I cannot have kids, but doctors can't take what God has in his plan. A to the man to that. That is so true. Like, the doctors told me I wouldn't have any kids because when I got shot when I was 14, they said I wouldn't have any. Wish I can see that doctor today. The doctors told me I would have no feeling in my left hand or arm, that it would pretty much shrivel up. Wish I could see that doctor today and be like, you don't know my God. Even though I was not a Christian back then, he still had a plan for me. That was my second chance. All right, I think I got enough in here now. All right. I can throw this away and throw this away. Yep, God had other plans. Yep, he has the final say. Yes, amen. We serve a great big God, an awesome God. He is the God of all gods. Besides him, there is no other. Yes, Janet. Yes. Y'all don't have us up in here. You know, the Bible say wherever two or three are gathered together, he is in the midst. God knew we would need you today. Aw, thank you. I appreciate that. All right, let's see how this ring turns out. I'm going to just set this one on there while I get ready to do my tatting. So I'll show you. So these are the, let me flip them over. Okay, that one's a little sticky. So here are all the bezel the bezel pieces that I did, stitch markers, if anyone interested. So I'll probably put them under the light again. Still here getting some grapes. You getting some grapes? Yes? Y'all, every live since the last three lives, she had to use the bathroom, and then I have to come and get her up. I just thought I was not going to have to do that this go around. But sure enough. Oh, thank you. So we're going to see how this ring turn out. So I'm about to go tend to her real quick. I'll be right back. She used the bathroom. Be right back, y'all.
Don't go nowhere. Don't leave me. Turn the light off too and close the door.
All right, I'm back. Should have got a paper towel. Sorry about that. What we miss? That's okay, children first. Yes. Oh, you like my mug. This is the one I did with Brown Girl Life and Just Handmade Designs. We wanted a cup alike. And so we got the scripture on here. It says, There is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother, but we put sister, and we put the scripture, which is Proverbs 18:24, and that's our butterfly cup. So they made one, we made one alike. So it'd be matching. So if y'all ever want a custom cup, y'all can come to me, or Just Handmade Designs, or Brown Girl Life. Thank you. It says, I'm going to subscribe to you all. That's awesome. Yes, definitely. If you have a channel that you want us to go and subscribe to, put it up. One of your favorite cups and one of mine too, Jess. One of mine too. I see your sticker at the bottom. Oh, yeah. It messed up, y'all. Let me see. That's my little sticker I made. All right. Let's see. Shall we pop it out and see? I don't feel not quite done. All right, let me get my tatting. I think I want to use this orange. So we're going to do some tatting. If you guys want to learn how to tat, check out my 3-series tatting video. Make sure I get the right tatting needle. And I guarantee you, if you follow all 3 videos, by the time you're finished with your 3rd video, you will know how to tat. You will know. Oh, thank you. Maya or Mia? I want to say Maya, but I think it could be Mia. Mia Bear? Maya Bear sounds right. Can I just use a steel hook to practice? You can. You can use, oh man, it's all tangled. Do you have a tapestry needle? Sometimes I may have those long tapestry needles. I'm slowly getting back to uploading videos. I don't know if I should even comment on that. Should I, Angie? Should I? You know I'm playing with you. Definitely subscribe to Jess Handmade Designs. She do videos as well. I said I was going to surprise y'all and just have a fresh off the hook Friday pop up. Fresh off the hook need to be resurrected. It's not a long needle. How long?
I mean, because you could practice just the basics of how you do your finger and everything. All right, let's see. Let's pull this out. I didn't have enough resin. I thought it was enough resin on here, but it's not. But I'm going to show you. So, I didn't have enough resin there. As you can see, that gap, it wasn't quite enough. But overall, though, that's cute. I like that. I might have to make more of those. Look at that. That's a big one, too. That's big. So, I'll definitely, maybe on that finger. This finger would be better. Look at that. I have one in here that says mom and another one that says dad, but I didn't have enough. You see right here? You see that? I didn't have enough. I didn't put enough resin in there. So if I would have had enough, that would have been perfect. Send that to you. I'll make another one, Jesse Boo, because you know I'm not happy with that. Look at that. See that dip? If I only put a little more. I'll do a purple one, Jesse Boo, because this one now looks a little blue. But I'll do, like, I got the different colors, all the glitter selection I have back there. I'm gonna play with it. And it has all different kind of sizes, so it has the smaller one. I think the one I used was this one right here. So it has different sizes. So if y'all want a custom ring, let me know. Oh, wait, who's leaving? Who's leaving? Somebody leaving? Thank you for stopping by. And definitely we're going to keep the fire that's going on out there in prayer. May the Lord come and just blow it out. Hey, V. My grands would love a ring like that. Just email me. Because I got all kind of glitter selection. You know what would be cute? A glow-in-the-dark one. But I'm not going to do it. We about to tap. You have a good morning out there in Australia. Good day. All right, let's tap. I'm like a size 7. I don't know what a size 7 is. I'll have to... It's not marked on here what the sizes are. So, I don't know. What I'll probably have to do is just do, like, the whole thing. Hi, Vivian. Holy Springs. Is that Minnesota? Minneapolis? See, you started it. I will put my request in. Do it. Hey, that keeps me busy. You need to link your email address. Oh, okay. Jesse Boo, can you put my, let me see. I have to pull out my keyboard. Yeah, I'm not a typer. I don't know if I can pin it. Can I pin it on here? Now, how do I pin? Let me see. Nope. Can't pin? I thought maybe I could pin it, but there's my email right there. If you guys are interested in any custom stuff, just hit me up. Oh, hey, Adele. Your mom doing okay? I do have a ring sizer, but I think it's in storage. So, because I have these, which are just plain, like, just the flat, which I really like that they're flat because you can't really feel it too much on your hand. Yeah, no, don't be sorry. Hi, Lisa. Are you crocheting some earrings, girl? And this one has, like, you see how it looks textured? I'm very curious of how that's going to turn out. It's just getting the resin in there. So that'll give it a textured look. Oh, Amazon. This late Amazon package came in? Says, please bring back Fresh Off the Hook. I was just watching some of your old videos. Yes, I'm going to resurrect it, y'all. You gonna be watching me on the TV while you charge up your phone? Awesome. Not tonight. You ain't doing nothing tonight. And I got a whole bunch of ring things, so y'all might, maybe next Saturday I'll just work on rings and maybe set up my camera to where you guys can actually see what I'm doing. But let me pull up my picture where I'm going to try to tap. I got to put it to the side so I can still see you guys' comments. There we go. All right, here we go. Here we go. All right, if y'all want to tap with me, you can grab your needle and your thread and get started with me. And what I could do, if some of you guys want to learn how to tat, after the live, I will put the link to my tatting, beginner tatting. It says, have you done a tutorial on reading charts? No, but I can. Oh, what I'm going to do, y'all, that's another video coming up. So there will be two videos before an actual crochet video. You know what I was just watching? Every now and then I do go back to my old videos and watch. And you know what I was watching? The crochet tag that I started up. And I think I want to revisit it because some of the answers I have changed a little bit. Because I did that crochet tag like 7 years ago. And so, yeah, I'm going to do it again. And I'm going to tag all of y'all. I'm going to come back to this live and get all y'all names. And for those of y'all who don't do videos, y'all going to have to do a video to do tag. No, I'm just playing. No, I'm not. I'm grabbing something to see if I can hang with you. Okay, Carla. So, let's go ahead and get started. Let me look at this. I got to figure out, where do I start? Let's try it out. Ooh, that, y'all, it was hard. Like, when I read this pattern, that was hard. And I know it's not, like, the exact pattern, but it's close enough. Close enough to where it looks right. What about a syringe without the needle to help you get the liquid? Yeah, that's what I was using, Lana. Well, a syringe probably would be better because I could force... You're right. I could try something like that. But I was using these because, you know, they disposable, you know, once you finish. So I just have to, what I did is what I added too much glitter, which made it really thick. So that was my mistake. So I know next time, don't add so much glitter. But yeah, that too. All right. Get a little sip. All right. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. I wanted to read something. Y'all, I got this book. Definitely check out Nancy. Nancy, check out your Dollar Tree. Because I found this book right here, Walking With Him, for only a dollar. And it has inspirational scriptures in it. And it's King James Version. Like, in different scriptures. For the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same, the Lord's name is to be praised. And that is Psalms 113:3 at the dollar store. So this would be awesome to get. You never went out to check to see if your package came. Oh, this is awesome to get to give away. Like when you see people, give it to them at the Dollar Tree. So you guys go to your local Dollar Tree if you want to just... you know, buy something, you know, something to give glory to God and a way to share God's word with others. I bought a whole bunch of them because I said when I'm out, you know, if I see some homeless people or something, you know, give them this book, you know, give them something that they can read that can in hopes edify them or help them or make them feel better. So I'm happy. Yes, I'm happy it is KJV as well. You can't, sometimes it's hard to find KJV. They have all the other watered down versions, but KJV is definitely it. So check out your Dollar Tree. So I just gave y'all that scripture. All right, let's do this.
All right, so it looks like it's a ring. I'm going to probably go with 6 double stitches. Neat. Okay, yeah. I mean, you could go up in there with $20, get 20 of those and pass them out. Keep a book like that in my purse to give away when prompt. There you go. Yep. Yep. Yep, Jeanette. Look at Dollar Tree. All right, let's see. We're going to tat it up. I have to leave now to prepare for worship in the morning. All right, Sheila, thank you for joining in. I appreciate it. So, looks like a peacoat. Look like there's 2 peacoats. So, I got to figure out. It's hard to see from a picture how many stitches. Did you start with a slip knot? No, I just started with the needle threaded. It's hard to tell by pictures because when you zoom them up, the stitches blur. So I'm just throwing a number out there of what it may be. So 2, 3, 4, and 5. Is that 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. No. So we're going to see how this turns out. And looks like I'm going to make this ring. Definitely check out the tutorial if you're interested. You're going to pull to form my first ring. Let me pull y'all down so I don't have to be like up. Let's see. Is it going to go down? Sorry, y'all. There we go. That way I can be a little more comfortable. And no, I didn't start with a slip knot. It's just my needle threaded. That's it. All right. Now, look like there's a chain. So do I turn? Maybe I'll turn and knot. Let's see. All right. It's kind of hard to figure out how many is that. Maybe 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. It's been an hour already, y'all? Man. And pull to form your ring. All right, that's what we got so far. I'm thinking this is where we start. Okay, maybe turn over. Good night, Janet. Thank you for coming in. Make sure you check out Dollar Tree. So, do any of you guys sell your crochet items? Uh-oh. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I meant I was listening to some of your Fresh Off the Hook videos. I knew what you meant. I knew what you meant. You do? You sell your crocheted items, Sandrine? You have a good night. Rest well. Gotta hit the hay as well. I tried, but the Sandman got me. I know, Angie. Rest well. Don't forget to talk to the Lord before you close your eyes. Don't sell anything. I donate. Oh, okay. Yes, I do sell my items. Do you guys have a website, or do you sell by word of mouth? I guess this joins onto there. Y'all might be doing this wrong. Am I? Join. Look like it joins. Love you too, Angie Boo. Yes, on Etsy. Yeah, definitely put your, if you could put your shop link, that way some can go over there and check out and see what you got. Grandbabies keep me busy now. I give away to friends and family. Oh, okay, Adele. Good night, Brown Girl Life. Make sure you guys subscribe to Brown Girl Life. I sell by word of mouth and donate. I sell mostly word of mouth. Oh, okay. My blankets and the blankets sell real good during this time of the year. Oh, I bet. I bet. All right, let's see. One, two, three. You do Etsy, Facebook, and Instagram. Three. Mine is all word of mouth as well. I give away mostly, I mean, baby blankets. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was going to say those are the big blankets. Let's see. One, two, three. One, two, three. I guess that's three. That might be four, but we're just going to do three. So, six, join. I joined. Y'all. Hi, Barbara. I love you too. I have not, oh, you got a knot over here. I will look at the tutorial later. Yeah, I'm gonna work on the tutorial probably tonight. Finish up the crochet one and then do this one. I wanna have tutorials in queue so y'all could just be like, bam, bam, bam. You do donations too? Let's see. Y'all, I think I might be doing this wrong, but you gotta try it once, and if you mess up, just try it again. Okay, I think. All right, let's see if this is gonna look right. I think it looks like a ring. That looks about right, I hope. See that? That's why I love the Addy. It's faster. A whole lot faster. A whole lot faster. Now see, I think I'll turn it. Yeah. Am I doing this right? This don't look right, y'all. Oh, wait. Nope. I wasn't supposed to tie because the way the ring is. It's hard to undo if you make a mistake. Yeah, you have to catch it at its early stages. You're so right. You got to catch it at its early stages before you tie your knot or before you pull your needle through. Otherwise, that's it. You got to start all over. In September, you donated 100 children's hats to the grammar school up the road from me. Oh, nice. That is awesome. Put my shop in the link down by the, by, okay. I'll put it in the link. Oh, disappeared? Oh, they won't let you put links on here? Took me from April to September to crochet them all. It says separation. From April to separation. Like, girl, what month is that? I wish you would see what I have over here. You would just shake your head. You just gotta try again. You have to be... Oh, you have to be a mod to put links in. Oh, okay. See, I didn't know. I knew what you were saying, Nancy. All right. So now we got three rings together. So I guess they join by peacoats. So let's just try it out.
I'm planning donating some baby blankets in July in memory of my mom on her birthday. Aw. Let's go 4. Can't hardly see the number. I'm looking at my computer, y'all, and it's way back when I was trying to pull the camera down. It is an awesome feeling. I try. We'll do another time back to my shawl. Yeah, make sure you get tatty needles. I'm hoping I need to get my wholesale license to where I could just buy them wholesale. So it looks like we join. Good night, Donna. Thank you for coming in. Make sure you tune in next week. I want to do this every Saturday. What y'all think? Think every Saturday would be good? Or should I go like every other Saturday? Because I don't want y'all to get tired of me. You know, you got this Saturday night chat and craft and then my videos popping up. I don't want y'all to be tired of me. What do y'all think? Every Saturday or every other Saturday? I make it look so easy. I was binge watching Shauna J. Oh, don't mention Shauna J. I miss her too. I want to start a YouTube channel to teach people who are blind how to crochet, but I'm scared. Just do it. What is it that you're scared of? Just do it. I do miss Shauna, man. It's so funny because I have her pictures. I mean, it's not funny. I have her pictures on my phone from back when, you know, I did that video, a shout out or a tribute to her. And every time I see it, it's just like, man. And then I have my Shauna visor. Man, please do some tutorials. I will. What am I making, Barbara? I am making a tatted earring, but I'm following a picture. And I'm trying to figure that picture out. Send drinks at every Saturday. You don't have a channel. Well, you have a channel, but you just don't do videos, right? Besides doing crochet, I'm getting back into making candles like I did years ago. I plan to name my candle line after my grandmother who passed away in 2016. Oh, okay. What would that be called? Every Saturday. We got every Saturday. I'm gonna try. I need this after the week I have. Great time to craft with sisters from all around the world. That's why I thought of this, like, because people all around the world. We had Australia last week. It was Brazil. I'm sorry. What happened to her? Yes, Shauna J passed of breast cancer. Yes, every Saturday is fine with me. Yes, I have the channel, but nothing on it. You can put something on it. You could do the crochet tag. Yes, I miss Shauna J. She was just a lively person, y'all. You get on her videos, you was gonna laugh or something. Okay, looks like it got 1, 2, 3, 4 peacoats on here. I have 1, 2, 3 peacoats. Let's add another one. Yeah. Yeah, she would have been having complications. She was a fighter, though. She was a fighter. Your mom died of it, too, when I was little. Yeah. That cancer, man. It'll get you. Peacoat. I did a peacoat. Y'all, this is hard. But I think this is it. I connected. Every Saturday. All right. I'm going to try. You guys definitely check out my my story, because if I can't do it one Saturday, I'll definitely make sure I come in and let y'all know, like, it won't be one, you know, this particular Saturday or something like that. Thank you. It's a nasty disease that, but aren't they all? They all are. I thank God every day. I'm a 6-year kid. Well, praise God. Carla, girl, be praising the Lord every day. Every day you wake up. One of my best friends got buried today, and I'm in my feelings. Oh, I'm sorry, Sandrine. I'm sorry to hear that. Well, you know what the scriptures say. It's once appointed for man to die, and after death, judgment. So really, the most important time of a person's life is not their birth, but it's their death and the state of one's soul when they die. So I'm so sorry to hear that. Yes, give God praise, Carla. I didn't even know that. I didn't know that. All right. I'm almost halfway done with this earring. It's not really a big earring. So I think I'm going to do... It looks like you do the same thing what I did. Okay, let's see. Let's see if I'm doing this right, y'all. Are y'all still working on your project? Because I know y'all got to stop. Stop and go. I wish we can do a Zoom. That way nobody will have to type. You just be in there. Okay, look like I do the opposite what I did. Okay. Alrighty. I know, I'm almost done. This has three pea coats in it, so. Yeah. So this is two. Hold on. Oh, one too many. What you say, Lisa? I tried tanning. It was a fail, but I want to try again. Yes, definitely try again. I'm telling you, it just takes patience. That's all. If you got the whole movement and everything and you're making sure you're counting your stitches and making sure you're doing the first half of the double stitch and the second half instead of doing two first halves and messing it up, you can do it. One, two, three peacoats. My mom passed on lung cancer 5 years ago. She used to work in delivery, and that is why I'm doling. Oh, okay. Oh, in memory of her. Awesome. Two, three, four, five. Yeah, try it again, Lisa. You just gotta keep at it. Just gotta keep at it. Don't give up on it. All right. I think I'm just doing... I did one half of the earring, so now what I'm basically doing is doing the opposite. So that's pretty much easy to do, just remembering what I did. So I'll show y'all. And then this will be so I'll record myself doing the other earring. So that will be the tutorial. This is going to be a small earring. It says, I stopped crocheting. I was in Minecraft form. I'm in my bedroom watching you on my 70-inch screen TV. My dog is not feeling well. I'm laying, aw. I got a soft spot for a 70-inch TV? Girl. that's a huge TV. I have a soft spot for animals. Like, I love animals, y'all. I have a mini farm, if y'all didn't know. I have chickens. I think the ducks flew away or a fox came and got them. Because we started out with 11 and now there's no more. So I think either they flew away or a fox came and got them. But I have chickens, I have sheep, and my dogs and cats. I love fur babies. Yeah, I hate when they're sick. I hate it. You love animals? Craft room. It said Minecraft. I was going to say, girl, you play that? All right, so now I'm just doing the opposite. So I did seven, I think, that time. Yeah, this is a very small earring. Do you have to have... You do. You do have to have good tension. It can't be too loose, and it can't be too tight. Sometimes I do mess up on my tension. Like, I think this might be too tight. But this is my first go-around, so I may try this one more time. Two, three, four, five, six, and seven. What kind of dog do you have? You have three chihuahuas? They are so cute. I had a chihuahua before. I used to breed pugs until they passed away. Well, they passed away a few years back. But I have pit bulls. Because you know where I live, we need pit bulls to keep the mountain lions and the bears away. But chihuahuas are so cute. They got like this little dog syndrome. All right, so if I can remember what I did last time. So I'm going to turn it around and tie, I think. Yeah, turn around and tie. She's a Chihuahua and a Jack Russell. Oh, the Jack Russell. Chihuahua and Jack Russell. Yes, ma'am.
And he's a Marcelle
in the hotel because this one, pet party is skipping. Okay, get the alcohol. It's right there. Go get it. Get down on the floor. Army crawl. Okay. Jess, you still there? Jess Handmade Designs, you still there? Are you still adding up hats? So you know you're going to have to show me what you did to prove you added, right? One, two, three, four. Oh, yeah, she want alcohol because her DVD is skipping. So she want the alcohol to clean it. You have pit bulls named Butters. He is half pit, half beagle. Oh, a peagle? And very, very spoiled. Yeah, I have two pits, two red nose. One name is Israel, and the other one name is Samara. Yeah, she's fine. She just want to clean her DVD. That's all. She used alcohol because she don't know how to care for her DVD, so they get all dirty and scratched up. Noah is sleeping. Elijah is eating grapes. You didn't eat? Okay. Okay. Ooh, y'all, I'm almost done. Let's see. I just got to repeat what I did. What did I do? See, that's why I need to write. What I do? You can leave it. You can keep it.
Keep what?
The alcohol. Man, that's what I need to write down. Yeah, you can keep it. That's what I need to write down as I go. But she knows how to clean them. Yes. He's a big baby. Your boy is a big baby. I used to have teacups. Aww. Chihuahua and Rockwaller. She always thought she was braver than a Rockwaller. My Chihuahua probably thought it was a horse. They do have a little dog syndrome. They really do. I don't know. That's just how they are. Let me see. Let's see. I think I did three. One, two, three. And then... Oh, yeah, and I did seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. What are you putting alcohol on? No. Oh, you could take it out. All right, we're almost done. This is a small earring. I don't know why I thought that it was going to be bigger than this. I guess I can make it bigger just by adding more stitches to it. Yeah, they do think they're giants. I think, I don't know, like, do you need glasses? Did he show I was need glasses? Google Duo me, so I will, my mom just tried to Google Duo me, so I will have to call her back. She's probably going to try again. It says, love pit bulls. My daughter has one, and my granddaughter named Cinnamon. We had a pit bull named Cinnamon. She passed away now. I keep my dogs till they die, y'all. I don't believe in. Let me see if I can come on my computer and let her know I'm live right now, Mom. Do I have any old texts on my? Oh, Mom. How can I find? Yeah, my mom's trying to message me, you guys. And so I keep declining it. So maybe she'll text me and then I can tell her I'm live right now. I forgot to tell her. I told my husband I was. Mom! Trying to put you on my laptop. Oh, okay. Okay, did it knock me out? Am I back? I'll call her. It was buffering. Yeah, because she kept trying to Google Duo me. I'll call her. No, I'll call her when we're done. She just wants Azaria to show her her new jacket she got. That's all. So I will call her. Y'all, I'm finishing up here. Let's see. I did the chain 7. So do I do another? I don't know if that's 10 or 7. It looked like 7. She just tried the call. I'm back again? Okay. Sorry, y'all. My mom she called and on Google Duo. And she said she was going to call too, but I forgot to tell her that I was going to be going live. So, all right. Let me see. Would I be turning? I'm trying to think if I do the chain, it's going to go that way. So, no. I need to turn it this way. No, wait. Okay, so let me show y'all what I got so far. As long as she's okay. Yeah, she's fine. She just wants to talk to Buttercup. So this is what I got so far. Oh, it's saying low battery, y'all. Don't do that to me. Don't do that to me. Where's my charger? Glad Angie ain't on here. Plug it up. Hi, late to the party. It's only one way. I'm gonna try it this way. I did it right. What about now? Am I here? Is it still buffering? Let me type it in so y'all can hear. Is it still buffering? Yeah. Buffering and freezing. Oh, no. I'm back? You hear me now? Okay. I took the charger out, so maybe that was it. It say 20%, so I'm gonna end it soon because I don't want it to just... We good? Okay. So, let me go back. Yes. I'm back? Okay.
When I was calling, I heard my big toe right here.
Okay, I'll see it in a minute, okay? Okay. All right, so it's...
I'm almost done. So I'm gonna try no buffering. Okay. All right. I don't know what happened. See, when they start calling in, I think it'd be messing up. So I gotta make sure next week. Tune in next week when I'll have no technical difficulties. I'm back. Okay, good. All right, let's see. I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I'm gonna just do 10. Or let's do 11. Let's do 11. I don't know how many that look like. It looked like it's probably 10. But just to be on the safe side. All right. Next week. Yeah, I'm going to try to do it every Saturday, you guys. So make sure you have a project ready to work on. Some of you probably got shows to do. Clara. Is Miss Clara still on here? Is she working on her crochet hats? Because she was telling me she had an event to do. So I wonder if she's working on stuff for her event. All right. I want to do cups. I bought the cup turner from Michael's as a start. I will say be very careful, you know, test it out, you know, read the directions on the resin, because some people lately have been trying cups out for the first time and they're having allergic reactions to it. So listen to your body and everything. If you start having some type of adverse reaction to the resin, stop. Like, don't continue. You've been knitting socks. Hi, Isis. How many did I do? I did 11. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And how many did I do? Dang, how many did I do? No, I was supposed to do, I didn't do 11, I did 7. Yeah, study and research. Yes, I definitely highly recommend you study and research it first. Like, I didn't get no allergy. At first I thought like I had like a, like my arm had broke out. Like you could see kind of like where I broke out at. I thought it was because of the resin, because sometimes I do use the resin and I don't wear gloves. So I thought it was the resin. And so I stopped messing with the resin to see if it would go away. And it didn't go away. So I was like, okay, then it can't be the resin then. Sometimes I do have sensitive skin. And growing up, I did have eczema. So I thought that was just a flare-up. And that's what it was. It was just an eczema flare-up. So it wasn't no, like, allergic reaction or anything. But definitely research it. Study and research. Yes. What is good resin? I started out with Alumilite. What I'm working with now is... Faux Rizzle. Faux Rizzle. That's Fouxrizzle. Faux Rizzle. That's what I'm using now. And I actually like that better than Alumilite. But I would suggest, you have eczema too? I would suggest Alumilite to start off with, because the work time, you got a longer work time with the resin. With Faux Rizzle, that stuff starts to soften up and starts to harden up and get hot really, really quickly. So you do have to work with that pretty quickly. I did too many double stitches. So good thing I found that out before I pulled it through. Yeah, Faux Rizzle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Yep, Faux Rizzle. All right, y'all. I think I'm done. Let's see. Dang, this is tiny. I might have to go bigger. I like it to be a little more dangly. Or maybe if I added beads. So it looks like I join it. You have sensitive skin? Yeah, so you might want to be very careful about the resin. Like if it gets on your skin and it starts to burn and all of that, then you know that, okay, I need to wear gloves. But it's just very dangerous. I seen a YouTuber on here who just started getting into cups, and now she did a video saying that the resin is killing her. And so my thing is, listen to your body. If you see that you're getting sick from it, don't continue on with it. Your body is definitely telling you, hey, no, stop. And see, she probably just ignored the sickness just to do videos and about the cups and all of that. And now, like, she's really, like, not doing good. Yes, be careful on who you watch on cup making. You can watch me. Not just playing. All right, I think this is done. Let me just tie a little knot and I'll show y'all. Because I'll have to stiffen it. It's a little wonky, but once I stiffen it, it'll be okay. All right, y'all ready to see it? Let me weave it through real quick. Yeah, scary. It's scary, yeah, because you're messing with chemicals. You're actually dealing with chemicals. Like, the resin is a two-part resin, and once you put those two parts together, there's a chemical reaction. There's a chemical reaction that takes place, and it heats up. So it's you have an eggnog latte. Ooh, that sound good. It heats up, and so it can burn you. So you got to be careful working with the chemicals. Yeah, just want to give you a heads up. I probably need to do a video just in case anybody watching my videos and think, oh, yeah, I'm going to jump in and do cups too. Like, you got to be very careful. Like, there was nobody that warned me. I just jumped right into it. And who knows? And you can always gain a reaction to it later on. Like, I've been 2 years doing this, and I haven't had a reaction, but who knows? I may later develop one if I can find my scissors. Okay, I'll just show y'all. I can't find my scissors right now. Oh. How do you stiffen them? I will show you. Okay, I cut one off. Let me weave in the other one. You should crochet purses again. Your swag bags are the only purses I make. I was just looking, I was looking at some stitches, and I was just like, that's a nice stitch to do a bag with. So you never know. May one come up. Sorry, it's cutting my head off, y'all. Yeah, you could just buy them from me. Just buy the cups from me, girl. No. Don't make them yourself. Just buy them from me. Yes, please do a cup video. I have a couple of cup videos up here already. All right, let me weave this in, and then I'll show you guys what I got. Excuse me, y'all, my sniffling. Gotta weave this in. Man, I don't want to go in. Come on. Okay. Yes, and I love my cup. Oh, yeah. I did. I actually did Carla's cup. I did the vinyl and everything on camera. That was so fun doing the coloring. That was so fun. Thank you again, Carla. I appreciate that. The love and support is just awesome. All right. What do I use for stiffening them? I will check them out. Yep, check my Etsy. Let me shake it up. I use this. It's called Stiffy. I got it from Michael's in like the paint area. Was it the paint area? Yeah, it was. I think it was the paint area. It's called Stiffy. Or you can use Elmer's glue and water, 50-50. But here's the earring here. It's a little wonky, but once I stiffen it, it's going to be good. Y'all ready? Y'all ready for the tatting? It's a little off, but this is my first try following a picture. Let me put it on here. If I had a jump ring real quick, I would put it on a hook. There's the earring, you guys. Like I said, once I stiffen it, it's going to be all straight. Right now, it's just a little wonky. Ah! If I could just get it. Here we go. Let me just hold it up like this. There you go. Yeah, I actually did it. It does look like the picture. So, it's too small, though. This is somebody who really likes tiny earrings. I want it to be a little bit bigger, so the tutorial might be, I'll have to switch, I'll have to just tweak it a little bit to make it bigger. Yeah, just from a picture. So, I think that looks pretty good. Let me show y'all the picture that I saw. Where did it go? I was trying to text my mom on my computer, and I think I lost where it is. Where did it go? Previous page. Previous page. Okay, no. Okay, here it go. Let me try to show y'all. Let me make it bigger. See, this is how I was looking at it. Let me switch. This is what I was looking at. You see how tiny it is? Trying to figure that out? That's hard. And as I made it bigger, you know, it's a little bit easier to read. But yeah, I think it came out pretty cool. I think it would be cute if we put beads right here. That would be nice. So I think I did good. I think I did pretty good from a picture. Yeah, it came out cute, although it's too small. It's too small for me. Like, I think we need to go a little bit bigger. Like, it needs to be, like, hanging down here and wider. So, the tutorial will be bigger. So, yeah, that was it. I could try doing the other one. But, yeah, that's basically what I wanted to do is get one done. So, I think what I'll do is record myself doing a new one and just make the stitches. More stitches on it so it can be a little bigger. Like, isn't this too small? Who wants it that tiny? I mean, I guess it's not. Thank you, Maya or Mia. I don't know. What y'all think? Is that too small? Like, doing it this small, you think that would be good? It will hang on a jump ring, so it will dangle. What do y'all think? Bigger? Because that's only like an inch and a half? Bigger is better, yes. Thank you, Creatively Created Crochet. What's your actual name? Always bigger. Yeah, I think bigger. I mean, this can be for those who, like, when I write the pattern out, maybe I'll write, if you want it smaller, you can
follow this. I'll do, like, you know, do less chains, less stitches. I hate to leave, but I need to take meds. I think it's perfect. Thank you. Thank you, Nancy, and I hope you feel better. Have a boss night. You did a great job on the ring. Thank you. Earring, I mean. Yeah, and so on the ring, did you see this? Did you miss this? Y'all who joined in? The ring I made? I really want to make another one. But this is pretty. This would be cool for, like, hold on, y'all. My husband just texted and was like, still alive? Yep. God bless you too. Have a good night. So that size is just right. Well, I'll make sure when I write it up that I'll also give instructions as far as the stitches and everything for this small. I think bigger would be better. Yeah, I love this ring. I think I'm going to make another one. Just make sure I have enough resin for it. Lisa, I don't know if you just joined and checking out too. Stay blessed and have a great night. You too, Lisa. And I will post a link to your shop. Because she do some awesome crochet earrings, y'all. Y'all got to check her site out. Awesome crochet earrings. See how to have enough resin? So mad I didn't put enough in there. But I know next time. So good night, Lisa. Good night, Nancy. It's probably time for me to say good night, too. We've been on here for over an hour and a half, I want to say. So maybe you guys make sure you tune in next time. And we will do... Buttercup, and we will do some more crafting. I'll make sure I have something to do when I come on here and chat with you guys. That would be nice if we can actually do a tutorial live, right? And like y'all will get first dibs because y'all here in the live, and then delete the live to where nobody else will get it. I don't know. I'll figure out something. So stay tuned. You'll see a tatting. Good night, Adele. I will send you an email Sunday or Monday. Okay. So a tatting tutorial will be coming up. Crochet tutorial will be coming up. Crochet earrings. And then I have the ear warmer that I had to redo because I want to do a different stitch. So I love you guys. Thank you for tuning in to this Saturday night chat and craft. Thank you, Jess. Handmade Designs for being a moderator. I appreciate it. I love you all. You all have a good night and keep on crafting. Just because I'm leaving don't mean y'all stop doing what y'all doing. So tune in next week where I will come back. And I think my battery is now saying 10%, so it's definitely time to go. I think I am going to come in at 6:30. I think 6:30 is a good time. Hey, Sharita. I thought maybe you left out. I see you still in here. My Coty, definitely. Check out Natural Way of Coty. Her channel, Jess Handmade Designs. Who else? Oh, hey, Cowgirl. You love my tatting? Thank you. Who else do videos? Creative. Check out her channel. Did she ever tell me her name? I don't think she did. But yeah, you guys check out the channels for those who have joined the live, those who do videos and everything, check them out. You too, Barbara. Have a good night. You too, Carla. Hit me up, Carla, if you... They said, good night, Buttercup. They said, good night, Buttercup. They seen you down there at the bottom. I'll make sure I'm here at 6:30 on time. Remember, it's 6:30... Pacific Standard Time. So that would be 9:30 or 10:30 you guys time. Oh, you're Dana. Okay, I remember that. Dana. All right. So thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to thumb it up. And thank you for Proverbs 31 for the super chat. I appreciate it. And I will see you guys next week. All right. Love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first and everything else second. See y'all. Don't forget, two videos about to pop up. My intro, tell me what you think. Be honest. And also the revised or the revisited crochet tag, y'all, that I created 7 years ago. Love y'all, and just watch out, because you just might get tagged. All right, love y'all. God bless. Bye.